In New Jersey, there is legislation that would strike from state law archaic language that refers to people with disabilities. That is advancing now in the state assembly. The Assembly Human Services Committee voted 5-0 to approve the bill, which would make hundreds of changes in the way state law refers to disabilities. The bill employs person-first language to ensure that persons are referred to as having certain disabilities rather than being defined by their disabilities. For example, a drug addict or even drug-dependent person will be replaced by person with a substance use disorder involving drugs or narcotics. So I can see people now in a panic, in a fright, calling 911. I'm being attacked by a person with a substance use disorder involving drugs or narcotics. So political correctness returns to Trenton, and they're changing now the laws again. They had a department. I thought they had gotten away from this foolishness, but they had a department back in the 90s called the Department of Women and Legislation. And they had people actually got paid, and they had a fairly sizable budget, people to go through all proposed legislation, current legislation, and past legislation to strike out any time the word man or men and change it to Tron or man and or woman. It utterly absurd. I think everybody understood the meaning of it. But anyway, looks like we're going back that way again, because even in this particular bill that was passed 5-0 by the Assembly Human Services Committee, there will be specific gender references cut, including one that refers to the Attorney General and Commissioner of Community Affairs as him. Oh, they're him. I can't take it. They refer to the Attorney General as him. Yeah. All right. Oh, the Executive Director of the Alliance for the Betterment of Citizens with Disabilities say this is more than a change for the sake of political correctness. No, it's not. It's pure, simple, basic political correctness. Right. This is what they were enforcing on the Smith College campus before it got out of hand. And they had things that you could actually get thrown out of school for lookism. They put an ism on this, and that means judging a person by their looks. Sizeism. Somehow considering a person of one size better or more to your liking than a person of another size. And then, of course, it gets to the point that no one should do anything that offends anybody. Well, that's fine in theory. But then there are people who live to be offended because they get some attention that way. And also it makes them a victim. And nowadays, people feel their life is not validated unless they're a victim of something.